be doing that tonight. That's fine. Yeah. From historic Buckhead, Georgia, this is Georgia Championship Wrestling and My Bloody Valentine. How you doing, folks? This is Kevin Hensley, the PCW Commissioner, alongside the Ultimate Pusher, Tyreek. Big night tonight, Tyreek. Five championships on the line, including the big one, Sean Nelson and Terry Lawler in the main event. But we're starting off with Brandon Cage and Leatherface one-on-one.
Yeah, man, this is going to be a blockbuster night. My Bloody Valentine. You know, I had a couple of Valentine's, ended up bloody myself. You know what I'm saying?
I've had my heart ripped out too many times on Valentine's Day, my friend. I know it all too well.
Oh, I wasn't talking about me. But anyways, this action right here, we got Brandon Cage in the ring getting ready to face Leatherface. And I'm pretty sure he didn't have a great Valentine's Day himself.
Well, we'll see about that. Brandon Cage, of course, a veteran of the independent scene here in Georgia, and has battled Leatherface for many, many years. Never able to conquer the big man from the Badlands of Texas, and we'll soon hear him via the chainsaw that he carries.
Oh, yeah, I just want you to know I'm not messing up my hoodie.
Oh, no, I'm going to put you out front. He's coming after us.
Oh, dude.
Leaving us commissioner. I can't control him. Look at this guy.
Look at this guy. He almost ripped up the GCW sign with the torn chainsaw.
I talked to him about that, or his handlers, I should say. A monster that never leaves his feet. Leatherface making his way to the ring against Brandon Cage here in our opening bout tonight at My Bloody Valentine. Television title will also be defended tonight. Pat Roach, the champion, will defend it against Marcus Adams. Brass Knuckles Championship up for grabs. D-Money defending against Chop Top. And, of course, Tag Team Championships, the Grapplers, will defend against the Unrated.
Yes, sir, but that's later on tonight. But right now, like I said, we got some one-on-one action. And looks like Leatherface is ready to chainsaw somebody.
We don't really need to see it turn into that per se, but we'll see. Hopefully he'll just slide the chain. Thank you very much, Mr. Leatherface. I think it makes me nervous every time I see it. Matthew Daniel, the senior official, is your referee. Bell sounds, and we're off and running here in Buckhead. And we're glad you're with us here on YouTube, GCW Georgia Championship Wrestling.
Look at the size of Leatherface. I mean, Brandon Cage is going up for a headlock.
He is locked up with the big man, and
I'm sorry. He's so big.
The size differential is a lot in this bout, no doubt. Brandon Cage has got his eyes right across the ropes. He's trying to valiantly battle back off his knees, but not much luck.
You know, giant hands of Leatherface going across the back of Brandon Cage.
Been feeling that for several weeks, no doubt. That overhand club's not going to help Matt at either.
Those shots looks like they're not doing too much of effect on Leatherface, but Brandon Cage is still fighting and looks like he's only pissing the big man off.
You know, I would say there's probably a 75-80 pound weight advantage for Leatherface.
That's it?
I would say so. Just eyeballing it. At least 7 inches of height. And unlimited power out of the Batman from the Badlands of Texas. Almost took his head off with that clothesline.
I see, and then a big old boot to the back of the head caused brain damage.
Leatherface stalking Cage.
Whoa!
Pretty much doing whatever he darn well pleases, including just shoving his face into the mat with authority.
Slow, diabolical. I mean, this guy is just toying with Brandon Cage right now.
But why get in a hurry? If you're Leatherface and you've got the power advantage and you're controlling the belt, why kill yourself? He's doing a smart thing. He's just slowly dismantling Brandon Cage.
Yeah, just, you know. 1, 2, 3, 1. Say wait, the ref is giving him a 5 count, which is right fair, even though he's a big towering monster, still got to enforce the rules.
Well, how do you chop down a redwood, fam? You just begin to chop it down at the base, and Brandon Cage is clubbering that left knee of Leatherface coming off the ropes.
Oh,
and the
big
Nene. And he's called for the choke slam.
And the crowd is right behind him. He hooked Brandon Cage up and whoa! A snap. Such a snap choke slam. That was quick.
Not a lot of height on him, but he still hit the mat. Very hard. And now Leatherface going down for the lateral press.
Oh, and
how about that? Brandon Cage kicked out. What about that, Tyreek?
That wasn't smart in my book. I'm going to be honest with you. But, hey, if he got some more fight that he wants to get beaten out of him, be my guest. I'm enjoying it.
I'm quite frankly shocked that Leatherface is being so cordial with the referee over that. Run to the corner. Hit the
wait
floor.
A minute. Roll up. Are
oh
you
my
kidding?
Goodness. Brandon Cage has pinned Leatherface.
Oh, wow. That is a big old GCW upset.
What is going on here tonight? What a shocker here in the opening bout.
16 years and finally I got you. 16.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next match is scheduled for one fall.
Back with you from the Got to Be Real Events Center here in Buckhead, Georgia, with Georgia Championship Wrestling here on YouTube. Singles action coming your way right now. It'll be Luke Stone against Velvet Jones here in Buckhead.
Now, you know, I know a lot about Luke Stone. He's from my hometown, Macon, Georgia. And the Super Saiyan Prince is looking to handle out some power tonight.
And it sounds like he got something to say as well.
So, just in case all of you guys live under a rock,
what?
You heard what I said.
What?
Oh, okay.
What?
So, we're doing this tonight.
What?
So, just in case you guys have been living under a rock, which you guys might have, in this big town of Buckhead, Georgia. I am the prince of all things, and all of you should be bowing down to me every time I put foot in this ring. Boom! Okay. Now, last month, I had a title match. I was getting close to winning, but instead,
that was unnecessary. You called it a piece of crap town. Buckhead is not a piece of crap town.
I mean, he ain't.
We apologize for Mr. Stone's comments.
He ain't lying. I mean, you know, he can't be mad for a guy keeping it real.
Well, Velvet Jones is going to come out here and keep it real for Luke Stone and keep him in check here in just a moment. From right down the road in Milledgeville, as a matter of fact, is Mr. Jones.
Velvet Jones, he's looking like he's mean and he's in a bad mood right now.
He's in a mood to set the record straight here, I think. He also is asking for the mic.
Oh, wait a minute. He's asking for the mic as well.
Championship. Would you see me going out here with my line? No.
Now, let me tell you something real quick that you didn't understand. Do you see that flag right there? Do you see that flag? You crying about an opportunity. This is the land of opportunity. And everybody in here is here making less money, paying for all the stuff. But you don't see them crying. They get up every day and they bust their tail because that's the American way. You do this country a disservice coming in here running your mouth.
Oh, chubby? Oh, I wouldn't take that if I was him.
When you stop fighting with your weight, you can come here and fight me. And if you want to run, you got to run.
Well, Velvet Jones turned his back, and that is a very risky maneuver for the veteran from just down the road in Milledgeville as Luke Stone is bringing the heavy hammers here in the early going.
Oh yeah, Luke Stone already working on Big Velvet, but Velvet, oh!
Velvet Jones ran right through that clothesline, delivered one of his own, Stone to the floor, and the crowd is on fire here in Buckhead. Velvet Jones just back in the sport after about a 3 or 4 year layoff, and said he just missed it way too much, and you can see the fire has not left this man in the last few years for sure.
Yeah, I see, because right now he is tearing up Luke Stone's head across that apron.
Luke Stone is taking a thrashing on the floor after running his mouth on the mic. Velvet Jones didn't take too kindly to that. His patriotism is really fueling him in this bout. Irish whip in. Jones with a picture. Perfect drop kick.
Wow, I have not seen a big man with a drop kick like that in a while.
Jones is quite the athlete. Really limber in that ring. And now slowly picking Mr. Stone up off the mat. A pair of headbutts drives Luke Stone into the corner. Whip across. Here comes Jones. And a big splash. Stone still on his feet.
Shoots Luke off right into the corner into the next one. Big Jones is coming. Oh, wow, Luke Stone. That's what I'm talking about, baby. He slid out the way. That's what I call ring psychology right there, baby. And looks like Velvet is in a predicament. And this predicament is in favor of Luke.
Luke Stone pointing to the head as if that was a smart maneuver. And got to give him credit. It was. It's shifted the tide in this bout for sure.
Right in the abdomen section, Luke Stone is now, oh, about to work on Big Velvet. That's what he has to do to make sure he keeps his big old man down, staying on top of him.
Stone working on the left knee here. Big elbow across the knee of Velvet Jones. Stone is not endearing himself to the crowd here in Buckhead. Already called it a pretty crummy place.
You know, I'm going to be honest with you, man. A lot of people disagree with what Luke had to say at the beginning of the match, but me personally, if I got screwed, if I was so close of winning the championship last show, I would want a rematch as well. But instead, he's in the ring with Velvet Jones, who, again, he's also said last show, he almost had a championship opportunity, but he lost out of. He doesn't want to be in the same class as that.
No, definitely not, but you heard Velvet Jones, and you got to agree with that perspective a little bit. You can't cry over spilled milk. You move forward.
Yeah, but guess what, though? Guess what, though? Sometimes crying over spilled milk can get you a new couple. Just saying.
Jones trying to get this crowd to rally behind him as he fights out of this standing leg lock applied by Luke Stone.
And when Luke Stone got a good grip on that ankle, though, he might be having the big man down, but he's on 1 foot.
Jones is up and 1 foot.
Oh, and a side leg takedown and right back on that ankle. That's what I'm talking about, Luke.
Just swept that foot out from underneath him, and now Jones is in serious trouble. Middle of the ring, can't reach the ropes. Stone slowly, however, loses his grip, and Jones will make the ropes.
Oh, and right back on the attack. Luke Stone is being a smart, smart guy right here, taking advantage of that 5 count given by the ref.
No doubt about it. Showing a lot of presence in that ring as we roll along here at My Bloody Valentine. Picks it up at a fireman's carry.
Fireman's carry, what's he about to do? Wait a minute, he rolled. Wait, we just saw Leatherface lose like this. Oh!
And it's not going to get the job done here, too.
Whoa!
Count.
Right back at the leg. Luke hits the ropes and another chop block. and that sends the big man down.
Jones is hurting for certain. Now he's going to hook the leg. The one that he's worked on the whole bout for that matter, but it only got a two count.
Luke Stone just got a two count, but he needs to stay on the big man so that he can get this W. That's how he's going to get back on track of getting back to championship aspirations. And now we have him in a half Boston Crab.
Working over that single leg crab, and that is going to be very effective, no doubt, on an already weakened left leg of Velvet Jones. Jones still trying to muscle his way up, though. Fighting with all his might. Keeping his country in mind here as he battles back against Luke Stone. Three kicks will break the hold. Jones trying to get up.
Oh!
Oh, my goodness. I don't know who that could have hurt worse. It's probably both men, to be honest with you. Jones using that injured leg for an armbar takedown on Stone. And needless to say, I'm sure there's plenty of sharp jolts going through Luke Stone's left arm at the moment. Jones gets ahead of steam.
Here comes the big velvet train.
Gets some feeling back in that leg. Two clotheslines, ducks under. Irish whip into the corner. Out of the corner he comes.
Oh, wow!
Hook clothesline. Pee-wee is down and...
Wait, was that two or three? Nope, that was a two count. Referee said he got his shoulder up right at 2.9 seconds.
Boy,
wow.
Pee-wee and everyone in attendance thought that it was a three count, but Pee-wee says nay, nay, and onward we go. Oh, my goodness. Jones even thought that the bout was over. Big devastating clothesline.
Whoa! That was a nice maneuver to get on top. And Luke right now has might have the pin. One, two. Wow.
And now this time Jones fights out of adversity. Oh my goodness.
I'm not gonna lie to you now. These two are throwing everything they have at each other.
Trying, artillery for sure.
Yes, trying to get back on top in that championship aspirations right there. This is what it's all about right now. And Luke, he's
measuring him out of this corner. Big head of steam.
He was going for that spear. He was going for that spear, that patented spear. He missed. That was steel.
He ate that steel post. Jones waiting. And how about a rock bottom from Velvet Jones?
And that is it!
Well, worse for the wear, but Velvet Jones is victorious here at My Bloody Valentine. Luke Stone put up a hell of a fight. But
yes,
Velvet Jones emerges with the victory. Hard-fought battle here in Buckhead. Fans will be right back with more action on tap. Scott Mason squares off against Hanson. Luke got some good heat with that promo, man.
Yeah, he did. He did. Man. Love it.
Good crowd tonight, too. How is Velvet not tripped over those laces yet? Good grief. Buckhead, Kevin Hensley and the ultimate pusher, Tyreek, with you for GCW's My Bloody Valentine.
Speaking of blood, this one may have it because these two have history.
No doubt about it, and it seems like everywhere Scott Mason goes, he finds someone that he builds a history with for sure. Long feud here in GCW, and well, it's built over to other places with our former heavyweight champion, Hunter James. Now it's got another bout tonight against Hanson. Georgia Grown himself from just right up the road, Scott Mason. Nice ovation from this crowd packed in here tonight in Buckhead.
Oh yeah, Scott Mason got the crowd hot right now. They're loving it. Here comes one member of All-Star Special, Hold My Beer Hanson.
Let's tell some of our fans about Hold My Beer Hanson, Tyreek.
Well, Hold My Beer Hanson, he can outdrink anybody, I'll tell you that much. But not only can he outdrink you, he can work you inside that ring. I've been in the ring with him on the same side and, of course, the other side. And I like being on the same side than the other side. Let me just say it that way.
Man that fights dirty. Man that fights hard, Hold My Beer Hanson, not really caring much for the reception he received here in Buckhead, but I don't think it's going to affect him too much whether the fans like it or not.
Yeah, it looks like he doesn't care, and guess what? As long as he got that beer in his hand, he's good to go.
This will be an alcohol-free bout, to the best of my understanding.
Oh, fool.
Maybe right after the bell rings, it'll change. Well,
and speaking of the bell, it just got rung and this match is now off.
And Mason.
Scott Mason, he wanted to get one more in, right?
Well, Hanson takes exception to that. And Hanson tries it, he does.
Okay, now that's not fair. That is not fair. Scott Mason did the same thing. He gets a great reaction. Hanson goes to the crowd, wants to show a little love, and he gets booed. That is so not fair.
Look, Tyreek, the Gallup poll is pretty clear. 100-0 in favor of Scott Mason.
Well, we'll see how that's going to end by the time this match ends. You never know. They may change their mind on Hanson.
Well, he's going to have to endear himself to the crowd, and he's not off to a good start. Hanson's not caring much for the cheering. It is deafening when Scott Mason's calling for it here in Buckhead. Fans, don't forget our next show will be Saturday night, March the 30th. It'll be the battle in Old Buckhead here at the Got to Be Rolling Event Center. If you want to find us and attend one of our live internet tapings, we are at 1200 Shivers Avenue in Buckhead, Georgia.
And don't forget WWE Hall of Famer Ricky Gibson. He will be there. Excuse me, Robert Gibson. He will be here, and it is one that you will not want to miss.
One half of the Rock and Roll Express, that name should resonate with a lot of our fans, will be here next month, as well as the Deathmatch King himself, Madman Pondo.
Yes, sir. It's going to be a big mess, I'm pretty sure. But speaking of mess, looks like Hanson had a good hand full of hair, which was a little bit messy, but looks like he's free now.
Well, I will say this. The referee, Matthew Daniel, has the shortest haircut of any man in the ring, so it's going to be a lot to sort out if there's any qualms about hair pulling. Now, Scott Mason does have the reach advantage here, so I don't know if this is a good idea for Hanson to go for it or not.
Exactly, but you know what, though? I have faith in Hanson, you know? He probably can get the big man down.
Well, Hanson, he's still tentative, I believe.
Playing mind games with Scott.
And two-man lockup. Overhand wrist lock applied by Scott Mason. Hanson filling that. Pulling on the bicep area. Elbow all the way up to the arm. And now that'll send jolts of pain as well.
Yes, it will. That hand isn't supposed to bend that way, you know that?
Talk about insult to injury, using Hanson's hand to get a crowd chant started in here. Finally free, but Hanson is worse for the wear.
Yeah, it looks like he got the hand free.
Some time to get the feeling back in his hand. Scott Mason also favoring his.
Yeah. You know something about Hanson? You know, it's kind of rare that you may see him, you know, in a one-on-one. You're normally seeing him in a tag team action. He's very, very established across the Georgia scene with All-Star Special as that tag team. But, you know, he still can get it done inside the ring on his own. And like I said, looks like he's going to be getting there, taking it in with Scott Mason. But, oh, he's got some heavy hitters coming to that chest, man.
I'm telling you, Scott Mason is no slouch in the slugging department. He'll outfight any man on the roster if he has to. And Hanson on the floor. Almost took out our building owner here, as a matter of fact, who was being a nice enough man to bring some food to ringside. Wow, fans, if you want a reason to come to Georgia Championship Wrestling, how about that? How about ringside food service?
Now that is amazing. Wait, does it count for us as well?
Well, it should.
You know what?
As commissioner, I should look into that. I'll check into that, Tyreek.
Oh, yeah. See, you know what? I probably could help assist you with this commissioner thing. I got some great ideas. And speaking of great ideas, Hanson just had one, and he got free by hanging Scott Mason's neck across the rope.
Mason should not have fell for that, but did. And now Hanson working on that injured left shoulder. And I say injured because Mason, of course, obviously wearing some wrap to try and keep that thing in place. I know all too well personally about shoulder problems, and Scott Mason had better be careful here against Hanson.
Come on, Hanson!
Now really cranking some leverage using that bottom rope.
On that left arm of Scott, now he can't throw those heavy clotheslines with that left arm. He'd be down to losing one. That's taking away the strength from the big man.
Absolutely, and with the shoulder issues Mason already has in place, it wouldn't take much for that thing to just pop out, and that could be disastrous.
Yes.
And Hanson may be working for that, as a matter of fact. But he's spending a lot of time jawing with the fans, and that could be costly.
Well, I got to be honest with you, now, that may be costly if Hanson doesn't keep the upper hands, but getting the fans to turn like they were just cheering, now they're silent, that would mess up somebody's headspace and give Hanson some confidence as well.
More of those mind games you touched on earlier.
Yes, sir. Oh, wait a minute! Spine on the pine!
Yell. Boy, the 2x12s rattled underneath that thin layer of mat inside the ring. Mason still favoring that shoulder after the hard slam to the mat.
Oh, we got a pin cover, but he had that shoulder down.
Mason,
and that right there puts more pressure once you lift up that other shoulder.
A lot of strain alone just trying to stay out of a pinning predicament here. And Mason channeling the energy here in the Got to Be Rolling Events Center. Back up to a lateral base and is hammering away on Hanson.
These two are throwing hammer blows and, oh! A little eat the feet from Hanson.
Eat the feet, oh, that sent Mason flying back into the corner in a crumple. And now Hanson taunting Scott Mason, who's obviously not in a good place right now in this bout.
Hanson just pushes him off. I wonder what she's about to go for now. Oh, that arm, of course.
I hate to say it, but anything you darn well pleases to go for right now, he's got the upper hand. Hanson's showing his wares here tonight, no doubt about it. Very talented, very cocky at the same time. Taking a lot of time on the second row.
It's not too good to spend that much time up top, and he paid for a dive, but no water in the pool.
Crash and burn for Hold My Beer Hansen. And now here comes Scott Mason. Clothesline. Back elbow. And how about a double thrust chop a la Ricky Steamboat? Big charge coming from Georgia Grown. He'll catch him hard in the corner. Drapes Hansen over the second rope. A ringside camera taking you right into the shot.
Whoa!
Mason dropping the right arm across. That left arm still not looking too great. Hooks the leg. And that's all he'll get is two.
We almost, had that three count.
Exciting action will continue after this one's over, fans. Tag team title bout is awaiting us in the wings. The Grapplers defending against Unrated after this one is in the books. Scott Mason hooks him in a ear nod, and Hansen battling his way out. Dropping that bad left arm over his shoulder. Good move.
Once again.
Great leverage move, but.
Big man moved out the way. He went for it.
Mason got it again. How about that? Drops it with the breaker.
That's it. Scott Mason picking up the win over Hansen.
And boy, did Scott Mason earn every bit of that victory here tonight in Buckhead. Hansen giving him a run for his money. A duel, if nothing else tonight, Scott Mason just emerges on top. We'll be right back, fans, from Buckhead. The Georgia Championship Wrestling Tag Team titles will be defended. From Buckhead, tag team title time here tonight, first of four, and here comes the Unrated. DJ Trigger on the left, Austin Thorne on the right, and they are the challengers for the Georgia Championship Wrestling Tag Team Championship.
These two here looking like they're about to start some trouble.
Very talented team, high flyers. Wise beyond their years in the ring, but they're going to have to be on their A game because the Grapplers are the master of manipulation when they get into that squared circle.
Of course, they're tag team champions for a reason.
Trigger gave Pops the shades, and Pops is owning it, I'm telling you.
Not bad.
And Grandpa got the other set.
You know what? Now that's a tag team right there. Pops and Grandpa. Let's get this tag team match started, man.
The Grapplers are set to make their appearance here in just a moment, having a good time tonight here in Buckhead with the tag team championship looming in the wings.
Looks like the Grapplers are playing some mind games, making the challengers wait. That is a great tactic right there.
Hey, I didn't say they were the masters of it for any particular reason. I mean, that right there showed it. Making these young upstarts think about it. Tag Team Champions about to make their appearance here in Buckhead. Well, no doubt who's in the front. That's Nathaniel Seabolt.
Mr. Seabolt. And we also have this Mr. Heat guy right here as well.
We call him the Grappler. They are going to be billed as the Grapplers. The only question is it Grappler number one, Grappler number two, or Grappler number 86? We have no idea.
Right. I don't know. This Grappler looks kind of familiar. I don't know. It's something about him. I don't know.
He does have a certain movement to his walk, if you'll have it, a little strut in his step.
Yeah.
Not too concerned with the ring presence of these two men, Nathaniel Seabolt and whomever the Grappler is. We'll just find the Grappler.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is for the GCW Tag Team title. Woo! Introducing first challengers, in weight in at a combined weight of 380 pounds, they are the Hot Topic of the North and Spectacle, DJ Trigger. Give it up for the Spark Riders!
I heard he has stock options at Hot Topic, as a matter of fact.
Oh, yeah.
WC.
Oh, yeah.
All righty, then. Hey, you know one thing I do like about this? We only have one masked man on that side of the ring tonight, so it'll be easier to differentiate between the two.
Right.
No shenanigans.
We got tag ropes.
Grandpa's going to hold the belts high and let everyone here in attendance see those GCW Tag Team Championships. They've got you running around like a madman.
Push, man. That's what I do. I'm the ultimate pusher. But we got Nathaniel Seabolt right in the ring starting this off with the Grapplers, and he's taking control.
I mean, right to work with this arm bar on TJ, or excuse me, that's Austin Thorne in the ring, I beg your pardon. Rolled through by Thorne, and a reversal on the arm bar. Seabolt's going to feel that. Back to side headlock. Seabolt works his way free. Tag team gold up for grabs. Thorne pushes him off. Shoulder tackle by Seabolt. And Seabolt wins the battle.
Oh,
and wins it again.
He almost got to him when I threw him by that shoulder tackle.
When is Thorne going to learn he's not going to be able to match strength with Nathaniel Seabolt?
But maybe he can match his speed.
Out of misdirection. Whoa! That worked. And an unfriendly gesture to the Grappler on the other side of the ring.
No, he was calling, you know what? He was calling him Grappler number one.
Oh, fair enough. Number one in everyone's book, I suppose. Seabolt is a little worse for wear, but he's in his corner. He'll wisely tag out. The Grappler, for some reason, had unstrapped and had to strap back up. So TJ Trigger opposing WC, whomever that may be, and now the Grappler is going to the floor. He's not having it.
He's unstrapping
again. And pulling his singlet off. Is it inside out? Is he really concerned with that?
Hey, you know what? You have to make sure it's not yours. You have to figure this out. You know, that's kind of a rule.
Grandpa's doing the right thing. He's giving him a 10 count. But you don't want to win this one on a count out if you're the unrated because, hey,
Title's on the line. They will not change hands on the countout.
Hey, if the NWA wants to let them win by coming up, hey, that's on them. But see, if anybody with some ring psychology, knowing about that championship advantage, they got to pin them or submit them inside the ring.
Well, the grappler definitely knows all of that and then some, so he's going to take his time, finally locking up with TJ Trigger's side headlock. By Trigger. Pushed off by the grappler, ducks under. Ducks under again. Cross body. Down goes the grappler. And a one count. Grappler's not having it. And how about the arm drag takeover? He'll have that instead. Thank you very much.
Reversal, shoots him to the corner. Big splash, oh, into an elbow right to the grappler's face. This may be it.
Beautifully executed. Great timing by Trigger to get that elbow flush in the mush. Grappler up to his feet, catching his breath. I think he's a little surprised by Trigger getting the upper hand here.
I think he is.
And the grappler. Proud. Go ahead.
I'm sorry. It's just I couldn't help but mention the crowd was sitting chanting for TJ, waiting for him to get back into this match with the grappler.
Thought that test of strength was going to go to, well, where it's at now, quite frankly. The chicanery, of course, paid off. A couple of hard left hands and a blatant thumb in the eye. Grandpa letting the rules be a little lax here in the early going. Tag in to Nathaniel Seabolt, fresh as a daisy off the apron.
Well, you know how it is, man. It's a tag team championship match. I would hate for this match to be thrown out on the disqualification from a single eye poke. He'll be all right.
He will be all right. Or I right. Right. Throws him into the corner. Seabolt eats the turnbuckle. And pokes Seabolt in the eye. Well,
an eye for an eye.
Good for the gander. How about that? An eye for an eye. Thank you very much.
We're here all night, folks.
Whoa! Tip your waitresses at the door. There's the cover. One and a one count. I take a lot more than an eye poke to pin anyone in this bout, including Nathaniel Seabolt.
Shoots him off. Whoa!
Great spinning slam. Boy, Trigger.
And it was
Thorne felt every bit of that.
Yeah, I mean, the knee went diving right into the pack. Oh, wow.
Hard left hand. The southpaw gets a two count on Austin Thorne.
Oh, see, nice.
See, that is a veteran tag team right there. Pulling them over, cutting the ring off into your own corner. Now the grappler is biting the left hand and the fingers of Austin Thorne.
I mean, hey, he did give him a finger earlier.
They need a tetanus shot after that. Rattler, quick jab to the chin. Sure if he opened the hand up or not on that.
Ooh. Shot right to the forehead.
Pair of southpaws on that side of the ring, actually. Here's an Irish whip by the grappler. Head of steam.
Oh!
And a back elbow by Thorne. Still a lot more he's got to do to get the momentum back, as you can see. Still in a weakened state, and the grappler takes advantage with a headbutt to the midsection.
And the grappler here getting the boot right underneath the chin on the neck. Right in the corner. Tagged by Nathaniel Seabolt. He's back in the ring. Double tag team move there. Shot to the gut.
Fans, I'm sorry I've made it this long in the show and not addressed the shocking turn of events we witnessed last month here at Buckhead. Chris Nelms turning on his brother, real life brother, Jerry Nelms.
Now that was something. And see, I'm gonna be honest with you. I got a brother in the business. I know how it is, and I did the same thing. I don't blame Chris. You get it? He has to cut off that dead weight, and Lil Bro was just a dead weight.
Well, we'll find out what Chris's Nelms' thoughts are on the matter and why he did what he did. I'm gonna actually ask him to come out here at the conclusion of this bout and explain his actions.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yes,
oh, really? Okay, I cannot wait for that one.
Meanwhile, the grapplers are dictating the pace here outside. Big knife edge chop by the grappler. Nathaniel Seabolt is distracting the referee wisely, and the grappler is giving a workover to Austin Thorne. Why is TJ Trigger not trying to help his partner?
I do not know why, but I would be in there trying to help him, knowing that the tag team titles are at stake. Come on, man.
You jump off the apron, you go around, and you break it up. That's what you should do if you're a partner. You gotta stick together. A little shocked by Trigger there. Nonetheless, Seabolt picks him up off the mat. Still keeping him in their corner. Tag opens him up for a hard shot to the midsection. Now that shirt being removed from Austin Thorne, so I'm sure a chop, yes, is coming. That one echoed through the hall here at the event center.
Oh, wow.
And the 45th thumb in the eye. Now one's okay, two's pushing it, pusher. What about 3, 4, 10 of them by now?
Hey, if the well isn't broken, don't try to fix it. You know what I'm saying?
Fair enough, I suppose. Hard jab to the face. Thorne collapses. Tag to Seabolt. He'll just chuck him over the ring rope. And he's got to the count of five. He breaks it at four. Chop by Seabolt. Thorne collapses into the far corner. Well, they're just beating Austin Thorne's chest black and blue here are the grapplers. More like the Punishers than the grapplers here tonight. Thorne breaks it up. Second rope. Cross body block. Can't follow up with a pinfall, however. And Trigger is fired up on the apron. He wants that tag. Thorne's been worn down, though, Tyreek. I don't know if he can make it over there or not.
I don't know, but he better fight and claw and fight and claw. But Seabolt, he has the grappler. He's in, and looks like he cuts the ring off again. Oh, wait, no, never mind. He hit him with a clothesline. This may be it.
Maybe now that's all the opening he needs. He's edging ever closer. And there's the tag. Here comes Trigger. House of Fire. Right hand. Right hand. Right hand. How about a side kick?
Whoa! Enziguri!
Enziguri by TJ Trigger. All kinds of fired up here in this one. Tag team championship at stake. Watch Seabolt.
Going for a tag team move. Seabolt just sends him to the ring post. It is now 2-on-1. Oh, and a Claymore!
How about a Claymore kick from Seabolt?
That might be it! And that is it! Wait, wait.
And I believe that is
yes,
all,
that
fans.
Is all it!
Wow, okay. Unbelievable, kind of a awkward ending. Tyree delivering the tag team championships back to the champions that have retained. The grappler, Nathaniel Seabolt, the grappler will walk out of here with championship gold still around their waist. Stay with us, fans. When we come back, we hope to get Chris Nelms to address his actions from last month's show here in Buckhead.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I'd like to introduce you and bring you to the ring, our commissioner of TCW, Mr. Kevin Hensley.
Mr. Hensley is inside the ring looking to get some answers from Chris Nelms.
Greedy. Hi guys, how's everyone doing?
Hi.
Last month here at GCW, we saw one of the most egregious atrocities ever.
One of the biggest turns of all time. Chris Nelms attacked his brother Jerry and left him laying here in the ring. At this time, as commissioner, I'm going to ask that Chris Nelms, the best reminder, come out here and explain his
Alrighty, Commissioner using his big boss card, calling out Chris Nelms to see what's on his mind.
Hey,
comes the Outlaw, the last real heel, the man in black, the Johnny Cash of pro wrestling, the Nashville Nightmare, Chris Nims. If you see Chris Nims walking around to the ring with that new King of Sports Championship Wrestling Take Fist title, he just won it not too long ago, bringing it back to Georgia. But now we get to see what the Nashville Nightmare has to say.
Chris, I was on the shop with anyone else here. When I saw what went on last month, I was in attendance, but I watched the
news.
Can you please tell these people what led to you turning on your brother? That is such a brother. I just cannot wrap my head around that.
Oh, wait a minute. Here comes. Here comes his brother. Oh, wait a minute. He doesn't even have a chance to speak. The brothers are at it. The brothers are at it. Jerry is on top of Chris, and now Chris is on top of Jerry. Oh my God! Somebody, I don't want to, you know, never mind. I was gonna say somebody to stop this, but no. I want this to happen. I want to see these two go at it. Oh, and a super kick right to Nims! Right to Chris Nims from his brother Jerry! I'm trying to say somebody needs to stop these two. The referees out here, they're trying to hold these two back. Look like Pat Roach and Shawn Nelson is in the ring, but these two are still at it. These two are still at it. Shawn Nelson calming the big man down, one of his tag team partners, actually. But wait a minute, we got some more reinforcements. Ladies and gentlemen, chaos have erupted here at My Bloody Valentine. Jerry and Chris cannot stop fighting, and here comes Chris again. Oh, wait. Sean got, oh, wait a minute. Mayhem is inside of Buckhead. Oh, wait a minute. Whoa, 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 wait a minute. We need some more help.
Hey, that's enough. That's enough. Now, you guys want a piece of each other?
Yeah.
I am all for it. How about next month, March 30th, the Battle of Old Buckhead? Jerry, Chris, you guys got each other. We're all
one. Oh my! The commissioner has spoken. March 30th, the Old Buckhead Show. We're gonna have brother versus brother. Chris Nims versus Jerry Nims, and Chris just spit in the face of his own brother. This is gonna be chaotic. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna get the chaos controlled here, but when we get back, we will have a brass knuckle title match coming up next.
Yeah.
Well, we are starting this action back off with some brass knuckle championship action. We got Chop Top going up against the reigning champion, D-Money.
From here on out, fans, it is all title bouts here at My Bloody Valentine. And the first one up, as you just mentioned, is going to be a war from the word go. Brass Knuckles title is exactly what it sounds like.
Brass Knuckles championship. And now introducing the champion.
Didn't cut you off there, Pop. Sorry about that. But it is anything goes, no holds barred. And Chop Top, a former Brass Knuckles champion himself, former heavyweight champion too here in GCW, is going to be quite the challenge for the title holder, D-Money.
D-Money getting right in the face of that little girl, telling her how it is, and that's what it's like to be the champion. You get to talk to anybody how you want, you know what I'm saying?
Got that cocky Detroit attitude, no doubt about it, does D-Money. Won that championship in September in a cage match in Macon, Georgia, and has successfully defended it ever since.
You want to know something? I actually was on that show in Macon, Georgia, and I actually won my match as well. So, hey, you know, that's something me and D-Money got in common. You know, we'd like to win matches.
No doubt about that. No doubt about that. Kevin Hensley, GCW Commissioner, alongside the Ultimate Pusher, Tyreek, bringing you tonight's show from the Got to Be Rolling Event Center here in Buckhead, Georgia. Referee Pee Wee has commandeered the bell.
D-Money, I know you were expecting Kyle Phillips.
Job of time tonight.
See, I know this whole Brass Knuckles championship that you have, you know, straight lines, wonderful matches, blood up. Tonight, I'm going to fight you for this belt in a normal wrestling match. What? Because I know you cannot beat me without a steel chair, without a cooking sheet, without a bar of wire. So tonight, we are actually wrestling. All rules, road breaks, count outs, everything.
Chop Top, known, noted, vicious wrestler, wants to win it in a straight wrestling match and no exceptions to the rules, I guess. That is
That's crazy.
Wasn't quite ready for that. Chop Top's kind of caught us all off guard, I believe, here in Buckhead. Bell sounds and the Brass Knuckles title is on the line in a wrestling match where not only the both men are just going to wrestle each other instead of, you know, pulling all the stops, but D-Money has waived his championship advantage. If it ends in a disqualification, Chop Top can still win the title. How did you need, to say the least, Tyreek?
Yeah, man. I mean, that's a lot of, you know what, a big thing of kahunas from D-Money throwing away that championship advantage. But hey, he can back it up, then let's see it.
Let's see what he can do here in the ring with no shortcuts, so to speak. As Chop Top said, no steel chairs, no barbed wire baseball bats, none of the plunder that you see in these Brass Knuckles titles bouts. As chain wrestling to start things, Chop Top with the go-behind wrist lock on D-Money, who makes to the ropes. And Pee-Wee will get the break. Top with the clean break. What is going on? I feel like we're in bizarro world here, Tyreek.
Yeah, man, got to be. But hey, D-Money, showing those effects from that maneuver he was just saying for Chop Top. It looked like D-Money wants to go for a test of strength now.
You know, I've seen this same tactic a couple of times already tonight, and so far it's not worked out too well for the other person, so.
I don't know. We might be in luck. We got two hands locked.
This time I believe we got it, and let's see how it goes. As a quick flip of the leverage by Chop Top. That did not go well for D-Money.
Oh, and he stepped on the fingers. He can't count his money without his fingers.
He definitely can. He can imagine his money in his mind. That's about all he can do. And I'm sure a couple of the knuckles have been shuffled on D-Money. Brass Knuckles title on the line.
Could he still be the Brass Knuckle champ if he can't put on Brass Knuckles?
You know, that's a good question. And, is that a gorgeous belt, first of all, sitting here at our table? But, yes, that would be interesting if he couldn't actually get him on. Could he be calling himself the Brass Knuckle champion? How about a calling him on tie-up into the side headlock? Still some very basic, germane wrestling by Chop Top and D-Money. So they're sticking to their guns so far.
Yep. We haven't seen any weapons, but now D-Money is heading out the ring.
D-Money's out the ring and in front of us, taking a breather.
He just wants to take a little breather. That's fine. You know, he is doing an actual wrestling match without any weapons. He's taking a little breather. That's fine. You know what I'm saying?
You know what? You know what I also like about it? He mentioned if he got disqualified.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
He never said anything about countouts, and now he's grabbed a piece of rebar that they used earlier tonight to tighten those turnbuckles.
If he hits him with that, he will lose the championship.
Chop Top's begging for it. He knows what's up. D-Money's frustrated. Chop Top tried to expose that. And instead, he'll just stomp on the pointed toe boot of Chop Top.
Oh, and a soccer kick, and another one. Three to the back. Four, five.
And the goal kicks are going to go for a loss as Chop Top goes behind with a quick roll-up for two.
Oh, and a clothesline sends Chop Top down.
D-Money brought the heat there on that one, and Chop Top is rocked for the first time tonight.
Ooh, head going right to the turnbuckle, and now those boots right to the abdomen, to the chest area. Stomping and clawing right there, trying to get out that corner, but hit that big boot is right there in his chest.
Chop Top loves to take punishment. He's a little bit of a sadist in that regard, but I don't know how much he can take if he's just getting clubbed on in the corner like that.
Yeah, take a look. Oh, Chop Top got a chop!
Boy, there's some meat being grinded in this ring. And D-Money, that's incredible. If they want one more.
Oh, and a back elbow to the face. Looks like he's about to get one more. That chop to Chop Top. Oh, the crowd turning up, telling that it's weak, and D-Money said, this one's for you. Oh, wait, he stopped it.
Blocks it. Chop Top.
Oh, and a chop from Chop Top.
Boy, that has echoed and popped here in Buckhead. All the action in Buckhead right here tonight at the Guthrie World Event Center. Three hard chops. D-Money with a splash in the corner. Both men's chests, as you can see now, are just as red as the Georgia Bulldogs' colors. And a two count. He'll be right there to count the pinfall. And a reverse chin lock applied now by D-Money.
Yes, sir. D-Money got that lock in real, real hard. Chop Top trying to feed from the energy of the crowd.
I'll say this, as far as sticking to their guns, they still are. It's still just a straight-laced wrestling match. No shenanigans so far, and both men are battling valiantly. The Brass Knuckles title is still on the line, nonetheless. Chop Top tried to break loose from that advantage and couldn't do so. Now he's already caught back again. Another chin lock on the mat by D-Money.
Yes, sir.
You gotta imagine if the Madman Pondo is gonna be coming into GCW next month, would not the ideal challenger against D-Money, would that not be how you line him up with, Brass Knuckles champion?
You know what, that may be interesting right there. I actually would like to see that. I think that D-Money may have trouble if he has that type of competitor on his way.
What a pump handle slam and a little too much on it. Chop Top slips out the back. Double thrust across the chest. Here comes Chop Top.
And another one.
The Dream Killer himself.
Ooh, a big boot pump.
But a bicycle kick by Chop Top. And a running knee into the corner.
And D-Money down.
He's looking a little groggy over there. May need to go back to Motown and recoup. He'll go to the floor. Now, fans, I will say this. As commissioner, I'm obviously fully aware Madman Mondo will be here next month. We just haven't figured out the particulars of his match as of yet. When you're dealing with a madman, it's hard to do that.
Yeah, you're absolutely right about that, because you don't want to put him in the wrong match. He may get mad at you.
I'm not a man that wants his head stapled. And now we got an interesting Pee-wee playing man in the middle here. And a sneak attack. Now, did you see that?
Jesse, what? He hit him with a right hand.
D-Money using that same piece of rebar from earlier.
Hey!
And got the three count. Boy, he stole this one. What a shady victory. These two men fought tooth and nail in about the most straight-laced wrestling match I've seen the two have in a long time. And you see the end result, D-Money ultimately having to resort to cheap tactics to retain the GCW Brass Knuckles Championship.
Love him.
What about it, Tyree?
Love him, hate him, he's still the champ. You gotta do what you gotta do. He didn't get caught, and I didn't even see it, but hey, I take your word for it.
Tyree, do you think a normal right hand chopped off would still be laying on the mat right now? Come on, let's do
it. I don't know, he took a lot of blows to the head in this match, I don't know. Maybe he's not used to a regular wrestling match, he did challenge him.
D-Money's got that swagger back, oozing with confidence as he returns to the locker room, still the Brass Knuckles Champion. Up next, fans, the World Television title will be up for grabs. Pat Roach defending against Marcus Adams. My goodness, Chop Top is cut open. That didn't happen from a right hand. Come on.
Oh, wow.
We'll be right back. Marcus Adams has popped out. He is the challenger tonight for the GCW television title as we're back live from Buckhead for Georgia Championship Wrestling's My Bloody Valentine.
Yes, Lord, it's the Ultimate Pusher Tyreek alongside with Commissioner here, and we are here for some action. We got Marcus Adams, and he is hyped up, ready for this TV title match.
Big bout for Marcus Adams here tonight, but he's got to face a big man if he wants to go home with TV title gold around his waist. And of course, we're talking about Pat Roach. And oh, by the way, I am so glad that in my absence, Ricky Nelms took it upon herself and the board to suspend that loudmouth Benny McCarty from ringside. He will not be here tonight with Pat Roach.
Oh no, I was actually looking forward to seeing Benny.
You know,
we're about the same height.
Only one.
You know, we're about the same height.
You might have an inch on him at the most. You're the only one that was here looking forward to seeing Benny. I can promise you that.
Well, I tell you who this crowd is looking forward to see, the TV champion, Pat Roach.
I'll say this, Pat Roach is more than capable of winning about without Benny McCarty around. And we'll see how this one plays out tonight. There's the champ in all his glory. No doubt heavily influenced, kind of an old school wrestler when you watch him work in the ring, Tyreek.
Oh, yeah.
Donned in that royal attire. Big man hovering around that 290 mark is Pat Roach. Marcus Alexander assessing what's to come.
I think a fan just gave Marcus Adams some roast spray, some rage.
Matt Roach just dropped his championship out here at ringside. Right in front of a fan is he gloating in all his glory, the television champion, Pat Roach. Now, if he really threw Roach spray in the ring, I'm sorry, that's a little bit funny.
Roach killer! He has some Roach killer!
Salvation for Marcus Adams in this title match. The fact that he carried Roach spray around the ring probably helped.
From Kansas City, Missouri, he weighed in at 275 pounds. He is the current GCW TV champion. He is the crown jewel, Pat Roach!
Make no mistake about it, Pat Roach is a very tough champion. Marcus Adams having some fun here nearly going, but it's time to get serious with the television title up for grabs. Roach has been a fighting champion since winning the championship. A title belt being displayed by Matthew Daniel, senior official. Pat Roach heavily influenced, of course, by the legendary Harley Race. Hailing from Kansas City, Missouri. Bell sounds, title is on the line.
And here we go.
Been apprehensive here in the early stages, circling the ring. No one wants to make a mistake with such high stakes on the line.
You got that right, especially with the GCW TV title on the line.
And the two men lock up. Roaches. Announced at 275, so I owe him an apology. I said he was on the 290 mark. He's obviously cut down a few pounds. And I'll tell you what, we got kind of a stalemate here in the ring. Neither man wanting to give an inch. That Roach slowly getting an advantage. Last second flip by Adams into the corner, though. And a clean break. No, not indeed.
Of course not, of course not.
Roach the champion with a palm thrust to the head. Ended that nice exchange, and now a backhand chop, uppercut, and another. Hard chop to the chest, snapmare takeover. Roach measures that kick right into the spinal area.
Oh yeah.
Of Marcus Adams. A lot of force in that kick too, folks, I assure you. And now a front face lock. I told you he's a throwback wrestler, but you know what? The maneuvers that he employs works just as well as 55 flips to the floor and anything else you want to do nowadays.
Right, right.
Wrestling is wrestling and forever will be wrestling. Hard right hands by Pat Roach. Opening that fist up at just the last second.
Right.
Keep it legal. Heavy elbow drop. That's 275 coming out on Adams. Now a chin lock applied by Roach. Right near the ropes, but Adams can't reach the ropes with his arms. I don't know if Matthew Daniel will grant a break on the foot touching the rope.
Yeah. Looks like he's trying to get that crowd back into it to get him some energy.
And it's a packed house, as always, here in Buckhead. If you will be a part of the experience, fans, it's 1200 Shivers Avenue, C-H-I-V-E-R-S Avenue in Buckhead, Georgia, for one of our live television tapings. They normally occur on about the fourth Saturday of each month. As soon as I say that, next month's show is on March 30th, the fifth Saturday of the month. That is the battle for old Buckhead. But if you're hearing this show as it comes out, you've still got plenty of time to make your way down here for March 30th's show.
Sir.
How about Roach just grinding that elbow across the back of the neck and the upper shoulder area of Adams. Now, how about the shoots the half to get him over? And a two count. Actually, I'm going to say Adams was under the ropes, and obviously that'll break up the pinfall. Roach in full control, right hand into the corner goes Marcus Adams. I believe my color man over here is just in awe of Pat Roach's dominance.
I'm so sorry. I mean, just Pat Roach is just a man, a beast among men. I mean, look at the size of him, and he's tossing around Marcus Adams.
Marcus Adams, not a small child by any means.
Exactly. I'm the representation of a small child, okay? I'll say that. I'm 5'3". That guy there, he's huge, and he's getting tossed around like a rag doll.
Now, of course, once again, Vinny McCarty's not here, so you win that by default if he was. We'll let that joke lie. Now cranking in the hammerlock on Marcus Adams.
Got him right there on the ground, and the crowd is trying to get Marcus right back into this match, but I don't know. That big old grip, those big old horns of Pat Roach, he may not be getting out of that.
A lot of clutches to have to get out of if you're Marcus Adams.
Oh, see, look at that. Right back down.
Snapped right back down to the mat. And that's a pinning combination. That's going to be a two count as Adams' shoulders are on the mat.
Yeah, shoulders were down to relieve some of that pressure, but he had to put them back up for that three count.
We've had to have some discussions with our officials about keeping a sharper eye out for chicanery in the ring. And I'll say this. All three referees thought have done a pretty fantastic job of keeping things in check.
That's good.
That last bout being the exception, but I can't really blame Pee-wee too much for that sneaky move by D-Money to get
again,
the win.
Don't know what you're talking about, but anyways, I know one thing. This title match here is getting the crowd hot. They're hot, they're loud, they're right behind Adams.
And we still got two title bouts to go, fans.
Yes.
We're far from being over. Adams is up. He's not really had, to be honest, an offensive flurry in this match. This may be his opening. Roach has got to be getting tired of just beating this man to a pulp. And Adams may be getting a second wind.
Shoots him off the corner. Excuse me, to the ropes. Oh, a drop kick caught him.
Beautiful drop kick. The rope spray hits the floor. So it must have worked. And now hooks in a half Nelson. Applying some pressure, now Roach is grounded on the mat. How about that?
Wow, the tables have turned. Now get Pat Roach, muscle up some strength. Get back on the ground. Get off the ground, excuse me, and get. Oh, wait a minute. We have the crowd here. They're saying stop that Roach.
Stop that Roach.
Haven't heard that one before. We should put that on the t-shirt.
I'm sure it's already available over at ProWrestlingTees.com. Adams is still in control with this overhand move.
He shoots him down. He almost pinned him.
How about Roach coming out of it, though, into an armbar?
Nice. This is some great technical grappling wrestling right here. Getting the advantage, getting the big man off of him.
Snapped the wrist. That could not have felt good. Hopefully he didn't dislocate it or at least break it. Something, either one of those happened. Roach is going to drag him out of the corner.
Going
down the knee pad.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, exposing the knee for more damage.
Well, that's why the knee pad's there, fans, is to protect these wrestlers from sudden dislocations and, of course, the mat. You open it up like that, and it is a wide open target for Pat Roach.
Oh, wow.
Roach is doing what any old school wrestler would do. He is just working a body part down and trying to pick up the victory by wearing down one specific part of the opponent. And now with that, it's almost like a, I don't want to call it an Indian deathlock because Roach isn't upright, but he's got him hooked in the same manner. Up in his hands.
Still got a pressure from his right leg on his left ankle.
He's
that most
definitely. Using Adams' body to his own advantage there.
Yes,
is
that
Pat
there
Roach.
Will hurt bone against bone, and now he has to come to STF.
STF, a step over crossface. Got that leg hooked. Adams stretches. Boy, with all his might, he grabbed that bottom rope. And I'm sure is very, very happy to be relieved of the pain. I had to take a lot out of Adams and a lot out of Roach, for that matter, to hold him into that position for such a long time.
Oh, and a nice slap to the face.
Television title very much on the line here in Buckhead. Pat Roach, Benny McCarty-less, is showing that he can make it without that loudmouth manager ringside. Roach measured him for a suplex.
Place shake.
I think the ring shifted about 6 inches on that.
Yeah, it does look a little closer though.
The floor rumbled underneath our feet here at ringside. That took a lot out of Roach though, because he couldn't even follow up with a pin. Both men are still down. Matthew Daniel administering a 10 count. And no silly stipulations waved off right before the bell here. You don't want a double count out. It's a draw if that's the case.
All right, and Pat is right back to his feet with that fist clutch ready, clock back, ready to strike. Oh, and he missed.
And it missed big time. Boy, did he measure Marcus Adams, but he ended up eating the canvas.
Now, that may be detrimental for Pat Roach, because you know how heavy he is, all his weight, swinging down with that right hand and hitting the ground? Oh,
how about Adams with a kip up? Thank you very much. An athlete.
And a right hand and a chop and a right hand and another chop. He's working the big man into the ropes and shooting him off.
And he went right to the kitchen sink.
Whoa.
And a shot in the midsection.
He's grappling on that left knee, that exposed knee that Pat was working on earlier.
How about the top rope for Adams?
Oh.
And an axe handle smash. Roach is down. Adams curls over 1, 2, and a kick out.
Wow. Pat Roach showing why he's still the TV champion, having shown a lot of resiliency, showing that he still has a lot in this match.
What resiliency being shown, no doubt about it, by Roach. Now hooking him for maybe a DDT here. No, he's going to hook him for a suplex. Roach is out of that. Takes it down. And another. Oh, he's got him in. What looks to be a Rings of Saturn?
Rings of Saturn is correct. It looks like he has him. Is he going to tap?
Adams is fighting, but I'm telling you, Pat Roach has got him cinched in. I don't think he's going anywhere.
Now he's shaking the body. He's ringing the bell.
That's it. It's over, folks. How about that? Pat Roach gets a submission victory here in Buckhead to retain the television championship. Champ retains. How about that, Tyreek?
The champ retains, man. Victory.
Talking about such a heavy hitter, and he wins it with a submission hold. That Rings of Saturn was devastating.
And that shows you his range as a TV champion.
He is a versatile performer for sure. And we'll see many more big things out of the big man, Pat Roach, as we progress into, I'm sure, the Battle of Old Buckhead. He'll be here in action. Fans, when we come back, his heritage title time, as Jacob Ashworth tangles with Alexander Lev. Stay with us. Main event time here in Buckhead as we welcome you back to My Bloody Valentine. GCW Commissioner Kevin Hensley alongside the Ultimate Pusher Tyreek as we're bringing you the four title matches in a row to close out tonight's television taping, and this one should be a doozy. A pair of young upstarts, I should say. Ashworth, a veteran, but still a young man. I guess Alexander Lev, just in his early 20s, set to take him on here tonight.
Oh, yeah. This one is going to be one for the books.
Holding up, that is the Anarchy Championship that he has in his hand right there.
Five-star championship.
Five-star championship, excuse me. NWA Anarchy, of course, doing its very best to get started back up. Landmark Arena closed last year. They've had two shows in about a three-month span here recently in Georgia. And still hoping to get the promotion started back, but at the last one, Alexander Lev picked up the five-star title.
Here comes Jacob Ashworth.
Speaking of the Landmark Arena, this is the Landmark Heritage Champion. He won that one in Ezreal's House of Fun, if he'll have it back at Hardcore Hell in September. That was an eight-man bloodbath in Kent, Georgia. Ashworth emerged as the champion.
We're now awaiting the big man to come out, and here he is.
A lot of gold being strutted around in this match.
Yeah, man.
And just to be clear, it is going to be Ashworth's Landmark Championship up for grabs here. Five-star title is safe, well, for tonight anyway, for Alexander Lev.
Yeah, and Sam, looks like his NCW championship is for safe right now as well. But like I said, that Heritage Landmark Championship is up for grabs tonight in Buckhead.
And Ashworth dismounts one bell before rolling into the ring. Undeniable he may be. Jacob Ashworth getting a nice hand. Crowd loves this man. He's had his own problems here in GCW. At Lev has cut off.
My pops. Name is Alexander Lev, and I am faithful.
Yes, we're fully aware that he is faithful.
Jacob, I respect that you won the Team of Sports Championship. But if you people remember, I thought the only championship he won in barbed wire. I still remember at Hardcore Hell, where you put barbed wire in my mouth and forced me to quit for that Landmark Heritage Championship. And if you're a real man, you'd put that on the line as well tonight, right? Or are you scared?
I very seriously doubt the unstoppable Jacob Ashworth is scared.
Wait a minute, is he actually going to put both on the line?
That is an interesting proposition by Lev. I'll stand corrected. I guess the King's Sport title was up for grabs.
Oh, wow! He said he'll be glad to. We have two titles on the line now, folks. Two!
Being defended by the same man, no less.
Wow.
Ashworth won't turn down a challenge. Don't you worry about that. I was going to pop for the introduction of these two combatants.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match was for the King of Sports Southeastern title, but now it is for the King of Sports Southeastern title and for the Landmark Heritage title. Introducing the challenger, he comes from Greater Poland. He weighed in at 210 pounds. He's Anarchy five-star MVP champion, your Messiah.
Are you faithful?
cocky young upstart, Alexander Lev.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, he hails from Royston, Georgia. He weighed in at 270 pounds. He is the current Landmark Heritage Champion. He is the current King of Sports Southeastern Champion. And he's the king of the Landmark Arena. Give it up for Jacob Ashford!
Well, his resume does in fact speak for itself. Lengthy as it may be, Jacob Ashworth and Alexander Lev are going to duke it out here in just a moment with the Landmark Heritage title and the King of Sport Southern Heritage title also up for grabs, two for the price of one. Now, as commissioner, I've of course discussed this with the board. Normally we try to discourage dual championships. Ashworth wouldn't hear of it. He's not going to vacate one when he wins another. Bell sounds and Lev is ready to pounce right out of the gate. I mean, unloading on Ashworth, who's all over Grandpa trying to get a breather. Faithful Alexander Lev is ripping Ashworth apart here in the early going.
I mean, can you blame Alexander? The man just lucked up and got a two-for-one special. One match, two titles, and Jacob is going to get it. And I really believe he may be a little less weightful, if you know what I'm saying.
So this could really be interesting. Both belts on the line here. Lev walked in here tonight with one title already. Of course, that five-star championship. He could conceivably leave with three belts to his name.
That is amazing, but Jacob is back on the attack. Big elbow right to the chest. Quick cover.
Ashworth also a heavy, about what did I say, 260, 270 or so, right around that Pat Roach range we were just talking about before us. A big man and a versatile performer in his own right. So anytime an elbow drop hits someone, they're going to feel it. And he's going to feel that jawbreaker by faithful Alexander Lev. I mentioned at the start of this, a cocky young upstart, Tyreek, but you know what? He's got a veteran presence in that ring already for someone who's barely been wrestling a few years.
Right, that is correct. See, Alexander has been on TV, he's been all across Georgia, showing, applying his craft, wowing the crowd, being faithful.
We've seen him on NWA Power in action as well. Ashworth is in control right now. Maybe going for a suplex on Lev. Lev blocked it. How about that? Lev gave up about 40 pounds here and able to block the suplex. Nicely done. Running forearm in the corner. Second rope. Clothesline. That'll take the big man down.
Cover. Titles on the line.
Royston's contribution to Georgia Championship Wrestling kicks out. At two. We've not talked about enough because we've had such a crazy night here in Buckhead. A lot of action. But up next is the main event. How about the Southern Outlaw Shawn Nelson challenging Terry the Rock Baldwin for the GCW heavyweight title?
Now that right there is going to be what we call a slobber knocker. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, absolutely. Terry Lawler enjoying his second reign as GCW champion since the revival of this promotion in 2021. Every time he thinks he's out, he kind of just gets dragged right back in. As Terry Lawler, he can't stay away, and he is a successful wrestler wherever he goes, including here in GCW. Shawn Nelson, no slouch. He's held that King of Sport title. He knows what it's like to hold the gold.
Yes, sir. He's got Alexander looking to breaking down these body parts of the big man.
Hey, what did we say earlier? When Brandon Cage was fighting Leatherface in our opener, and he chopped down a big man, he chopped him down to size. Got to go after the knees. And Lev is doing just that. Now he's got a paintbrush at Ashworth, though. That's a little uncalled for, and that'll just fire the big man up.
Yeah, that may have been a mistake, because now those clubbing blows are getting thrown at him. But, hey, Alexander is still on top of him. That's what you got to do.
That's that cockiness coming out that I was speaking about, but he's still got the advantage.
Right back to that right, excuse me, that left knee on that leg.
Slams hard down on the canvas. And really just hammering the backside of that leg. A lot of tendons back there that could easily just snap. And you don't want that. I love just blatantly choking Ashworth right in front of Grandpa.
Right in front of him. He almost got disqualified.
He's not having it. Ashworth can't get up. That knee's a little tender at the moment.
Still fighting back.
Overhand clubs, elbows being exchanged between both men. And now Lev will whip the unstoppable one into the ropes. It's reversed.
Oh! And a takedown.
What a leverage move by Lev just to slam Jacob Ashworth to the mat.
Almost had a three count. We almost had two new championship changes.
In one match.
In one match.
This has been a unique night for title defenses. We've had the Brass Knuckles Championship defended in a quote-unquote straight wrestling match.
Yes.
And now we've got two titles on the line in one contest.
Yes, and speaking of one title, the other title, the Landmarks Heritage Championship, dating all the way back from 1999, back around the time when the Wildside Arena had opened up.
That's correct. A lot of history, a lot of... A lot of talented superstars that you guys watch on television every single week now at a national level have came through NWA Wildside and Anarchy, of course, later on through that historic Landmark Arena about, 2 hours or so north of us on 441 in Cornelia, Georgia. Single crab now applied by Alexander Lev. He's standing just to give more leverage. Ashworth feeling that, trying to power out. And does so.
And he does.
Lev rolls to the floor too.
But how much did that take out of Jacob though? He's still down.
Lev's getting a chance at a good breather here as Grandpa's not even paying attention. But Lev being on the outside, he's checking Ashworth. Lev's looking back in the ring slowly. He better not take too much time. How about the uppercut? Ashworth stumbling.
Right back into that corner. Showing off for that little cockiness like we talked about earlier, but hey, he's backing it up. Oh, wait a minute.
Shots blocked. Here comes Ashworth. Two right hands in succession, making three. Lev off the ropes. Clothesline. Back elbow. Sidewalk slam. Oh, rattled the floor here in Buckhead.
The big man, he's going wild. He's trying to pump some energy back in that left leg, but he is pumped up. The adrenaline is rushing. This may be the end.
Picks him up overhead.
Fireman's carry. Oh, wait a minute.
Carry slam. That knee buckled. Ashworth got it, but the knee buckled.
He couldn't hop on that cover just fast enough. That knee buckled.
And they've been all Lev needed just to catch one extra breath to kick out at two. Ashworth trying to retain. Lev trying to leave with about 20 pounds extra in his carry-on.
All right.
Here in Buckhead.
Wait a minute.
Now, wait. What is Lev doing? He's unrolling his wrist tape.
His wrist tape probably is a little too tight. You know, this is the match towards, you know, they've been in there a little while. You know, it might have been some circulation or something.
I mean, fair enough, I suppose.
Well, speaking of circulation, now his circulation is getting cut off.
He's choking him with the tape. Come
but
on.
He can't, but the referee can't see him. The referee cannot see it.
I mean, come on. Grandpa's got to be smarter than that. He's got to know that there's something going on there. Lev's not just choking with his bare hands.
Oh, wait a minute. But he's checking his arms.
Is this? Wait a second. Wait a minute. Hold on a minute. What just happened? Did Alexander Lev just... He just choked. Hey, Grandpa, come on. He choked Ashworth out. No. There you go. Well, Lev's not as wise as he seems. He fell right out. Choked him out. Thank you, Grandpa.
Triple H.
Grandpa saw it. How about that?
Wait a minute. Is he reversing his decision?
I think you're going okay. I'm going to think you're... Let's see what Pops has to say here.
This is not
fair! Three, how about that? Now that's clean as a whistle, baby. Ashworth retains his championships. Love is in a state of shock. Justice prevails here in Buckhead. Oh yeah. It's a beautiful moment, Tyreek.
No, 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 no. This right here is blasphemy. I mean, he literally won. One, two, three. Excuse me. No, he choked him out, but he got screwed. One, two, three over a quick roll-up. He wasn't even ready for the match to start again. Alexander just got screwed.
You want to talk about blasphemy? How about the fact that he went into the good book at the very front of it and stole the victory to start with that Alexander left, and the referee fortunately saw the turn of events, changed it around, and now
listen,
right.
Listen. Grandpa is just getting old. He's seen that tape on the ground and thought that he did what he did. He didn't see anything. Jacob ought to have no championships right now. Alexander ought to be holding up all three.
Now, wait just a minute here. This is interesting. Both men facing off center ring in this post-match. Lev snuck to win, and now both men kind of, how about some mutual respect, I
mutual
believe.
Respect, huh?
Gotta like that. Lev's not happy, of course. His shenanigans did not work out.
But he tried, and that's what the respect maybe is coming from. E for effort.
Ashworth retains. We'll be back with the heavyweight title match. Terry the Rocker Lawler defending against the Southern Outlaw, Sean Nelson.
Wee, it's time for the main event, y'all.
Hey, good night, Buckhead.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for our main event.
Here comes Sean Nelson. And also being accompanied by the man who screwed over his brother, and he will face his brother March 30th. We have Chris Nelms.
I'm not even going to dignify that with a response, but we do have that bout next month. The Nelms brothers will clash here in Buckhead as part of the battle of all Buckhead. But right now, the other member of the Dirt Road Dynasty has a crack at the Big Cheese, the heavyweight championship of the world. Up for grabs here in just a moment. And Terry Lawler's history against the Dirt Road Dynasty, certainly well documented. And already a disadvantage.
Right.
With that other Nelms brother slinking out from the backstage area to accompany Sean Nelson to the ring. I'm sure he doesn't have a manager's license either.
Hey, well, you know.
Come on. Well, things were a little in order most of the night, fans. It seems like everything's out of control now as we get deeper into the evening. Things get a little lax.
Here comes the GCW Heavyweight Champion.
And this crowd is ready. They're literally brimming with anticipation as the champion, Terry Lawler, a crowd favorite and a heck of a performer for that matter, makes his way out with that heavyweight title in his left hand. I don't know, over here to our left, Sean Nelson and Chris Nelms are discussing something. There's no telling what those two are thinking as Lawler makes his way around ringside. What could they be plotting?
Who knows? But hey, whatever they're plotting, I'm pretty sure it's going to be a recipe for him to leave champion.
I suppose when it's a heavyweight title match, you got to plot whatever you think it'll take to win it, right?
I mean, any championship match in that matter, but absolutely.
Well, for all the marbles, this will put you at the top of the food chain here at GCW. Waller paused on making his rounds out here at ringside. Just a moment, I think he's just about ready to pop in the ring now. Here in Buckhead, heavyweight championship will soon be on the line.
Sir.
And I dare say this, Terry Lawler, who as you see on the back of his ring jacket, began wrestling the year I was born, 1989, thank you very much.
1989, I don't want to tell you the year I was born, then hey.
Best shape of his career, though, is what I'm getting at.
Yeah. Showing how bad they hate Shawn Nelson.
I'm sure he didn't expect an ovation. I will say this, that belt is shining tonight. Lawler's got it polished.
Now that there is a title.
GCW's pride from Memphis, Tennessee, Terry the Rocker Lawler will be facing off with the Southern Outlaw Shawn Nelson. Heavyweight title time here in Buckhead. Belt laid down in the corner with Lawler's jacket. Both men pacing like caged tigers. And the bell sounds. No time to waste. It's heavyweight championship time here in Buckhead. This is what they all came to see.
Oh,
and
Nelson
immediately takes a powder. How about that?
Ain't nothing wrong with that, you know. Nobody necessarily said that the match had to start as soon as the bell rings.
Yeah, but he's not the champion. He doesn't have that advantage of logic. I can just go get counted out.
Well, I'm going to be honest with you. This championship advantage tonight has been wacky, so hey.
That's true. That's a very valid point, Tyreek. Nelson's not locking up with Lawler. And Terry Lawler likes to be easygoing in the early going, but I think he's going to lose his patience if Shawn Nelson doesn't have some combative action with him in just a moment. Chris Nels gets his hand stomped on. Good. He shouldn't have been leaned up on the apron anyway. What is he still doing out here?
Look like he got rocked.
Finally, the two men lock up here in the title bout, and Nelson quickly flipped to the ropes. Having a little bit of verbal sparring with our senior official, Matthew Daniel.
Yes, sir. Back in the collar and elbow tie-up.
I think Daniel saw that out of the corner of his eye. Chris Nelms getting a little too involved. And Daniel pleading.
Wait a minute, the referee!
Good!
He just threw out Chris Nelms!
Good! Thank you!
He didn't do anything wrong!
That's the best thing Matthew Daniel's done in months here in GCW. He's tired of the abuse, he's tired of the cheating. He's the senior official, and as the commissioner, I'm all for that. Get him out of here.
Of course you are.
I've watched enough of Chris Nelms and his crap for the last 2 years out of this Dirt Road dynasty.
Well, now we have a one-on-one match. Wait a minute, is that Pat Roach?
Yes, that is Pat Roach. Now he's sticking out of the back. trying to hide in the corner. I don't know that a man that size can hide.
Yeah, I'm going to say that's a big-ass roach trying to hide right there, dog.
Lawler's got a chair. He's had enough. I knew he'd eventually get tired of this.
Wait a minute.
It's been a circus from the word go. And he's just going to sit here and wait for Shawn Nelson. Good.
Getting the crowd into it as well.
I like it. I like it. How did Matthew Daniel not see Pat Roach hanging out in the corner? Roach, what is he up to?
I don't know what he's up to, but I mean,
besides coming out here wearing a Yankees shirt for Pete's sake, what is he up to?
Terry Lawler got him in the corner, but referee backed him out. Shawn Nelson is finally free.
I mean, here's the thing. Lawler has already had to face basically a 3-on-1 match here. Nelms is gone, but Roach is out here now. Lawler's got to have eyes in the back of his head.
Got the hammer locked there.
And he's still got the upper hand on the Southern Outlaw. GCW World Heavyweight Title.
Oh, roll-ups!
And a two count. Nelson not going to go down that quickly.
We've seen some upsets like that tonight, so who knows?
We have seen some upsets with that very maneuver tonight. Not once, but twice. Don't know if it'll be thrice. Nelson and Daniels sparring again. And another lockup into the corner. Daniel trying to keep Pat Roach back, but you know, I'm a little unclear as to why he hadn't just told Pat Roach at the showers. I don't like the Pat Roach out here for some reason. That makes me uncomfortable.
I mean, Pat Roach maybe just wanted a better look at the championship match. I think his partner is in the match as well. And then, of course, Chris Nelms just got ejected, so why not? He wanted somebody to have his back.
Shawn Nelson is a well-seasoned grappler. He does not need moral support on the floor. See, like that right there, Roach just grabbed Lawler's leg. That's the second person to do that in this match. Matthew Daniel is asking the crowd, and they're giving the affirmation.
Whoa, wait a minute. I mean, the crowd has no
business
getting inside of this match.
Everything.
Oh, no!
He's gone. Get him out of here. Yes,
that
sir.
That is gone.
That is beautiful. Matthew Daniel gets an A-plus tonight for his officiating. Television champion is going to have to sulk back to the locker room, as you see.
But Terry Lawler.
Into the shadows.
But the damage has been done already. Terry Lawler is already down.
Nelson has been beating him unmercifully since the ejection. Lawler distracted like the rest of us. And Nelson's got him down, as you see in the ring here. Maybe we could finally have a freaking championship match now.
Yeah, maybe we can. But I see Terry Lawler is still getting worked up in that arm. It looks like he's getting worked right down to the ground.
Nelson's standing on the right around the elbow area. Lawler's arm. Oh, baby. Oh, Lawler felt that. Back up to his feet. Gets the arm loose. Don't want to keep that hanging out there too long. How about the neck breaker from the champion? Two count. Nelson gets the shoulder up. It's 1-on-1 the way it should be for the heavyweight title here in GCW. What about the design on the back of Shawn Nelson's truck? I don't even want to ask. Never mind. Forget about that. Let's go tell him what that is. I'm sorry.
No telling, but hey.
Irish whip into the ropes. Nelson ducks down. Bad move. Veteran Lawler takes advantage. Crush your leg sweep. And a two count. All of those clubbering rights.
Oh, and an eye poke right in the eye of Terry Lawler.
If there's one thing I need to discuss with the officials, it's the lack of disqualifications on eye pokes. There's been about 700 here tonight, and no one's been rung up on them to this point. Nelson now applies like a reverse chin lock on the mat here. Lawler trying to fight. Now trying to help him do so.
Yes, sir.
My Bloody Valentine has more than delivered, Tyreek, to say the very least. And if you guys want to see the deliveries in person, March the 30th, the battle for Old Buckhead is going to be the place to be in Buckhead, Georgia. Robert Gibson, Madman Mondo, Chris and Jerry Nelms clashing. That's already been signed.
Exactly. Hey, hey, and guess what? I'll be back as well. So, you know, that's a plus.
Yes, Tyreek will be back, fans. That is correct.
But you know what? Speaking of back, Sean Nelson's on the pack of Terry Lawler now with the sleeper hold. And if he goes night-night, hey, we'll have a new champion.
That's correct. Pat Roach has already retained the title here tonight via submission. If Lawler's out, that's a submission. And that arm drops. It's pretty limp, I'm not going to lie. That's one, two. Matthew Daniel right there to keep a close eye. Hey, my monitor went out. What happened there?
Hey, looks like somebody got caught.
Well, you do what you got to do in a title belt.
I told you that.
And I'll say this, for all the crap that went on outside in the early part of this match, good for Terry Lawler. How about that? He deserves to get a low blow in if he'll have it. And now there comes those fisticuffs. Lefts, jabs, circling. How in the world is Nelson still on his feet? And a little flip-flop and fly to finish it off. Thank you very much.
Oh, wow.
And now Lawler climbing up to the second rope. Here we go.
Count.
The crowd here in Buckhead makes it to 10. Lawler's down, energized. Nelson, now he's got those feet on the top rope. Hey, hey!
Almost.
Now wait a minute.
I don't think he didn't tell me to ring the bell yet. I don't think
he did it. Matthew Daniels questioning that. He saw it. He couldn't stop the three count. That was the only problem. He was in motion. Match continues. Another flip ball. Nelson cuts it off.
All right,
with
the second
what
time.
Else? A thumb to the eye.
The second time going to the eye. He ain't going to be able to see after too much while.
Now Lawler flips him over. Lawler's feet on the ropes. And Matthew Daniels saw it and let it go.
He let it go?
Oh, my goodness. Now, I don't know about that. That's a little, that's a little much.
You probably need to do something about that, dog. That ain't right. Hey, you need to do something about that now. I wouldn't let that slide if that was me. I hope you're about to go fix this, because Sean Nelson is not one man I want to piss off. And here comes Chris Nelms. Chris Nelms back inside the ring. You know, Sean Nelson is grabbing the microphone, and now we're about to see his reaction to being screwed out of the GCW Championship. Right now are giving Sean Nelson a hard time.
Next
Oh, wow. Commissioner making it big. He's making it known. Shawn Nelson, Jacob Ashworth, March 30th, Old Buckhead, baby. Let's get it. Wow.
I got it, Chris.
You all got
it? I got it.
Shawn Nelson basically telling that the boys are going to stay in the back.
I got one more for you, Kevin. Referee Matthew Ford cannot be the referee.
And that right there should be added because he messed up on this three count.
All right, March 30th, Shawn Nelson and Jacob Ashworth. And don't forget, Chris, you got Terry against one too, brother.